Ah, I will smack you around my garden. Hey, you. You're wet. It is so wet out here. We've had about 3 days of rain, then no rain, then rain, then no rain, then sprinkling, then rain, then rain, then sprinkling, then no rain, then rain. It is wet. It is wet here. And I am darn lucky that I have raised beds. People have asked me, Ray, what is the benefits of raised beds? Well, I'll tell you, if you live in Minnesota, the benefit of raised beds is they generally do not get that soaked with water. You know, a regular garden bed can flood with water when you have too much rain. But raised beds generally have compost added to them, other kinds of stuff added to them. So the water drains out a little bit easier. And I gotta say, I am lucky that I have raised beds. With all the rain that's been coming on, holy crap, I would have been doing hydroponics if I didn't have a raised bed. But when you walk through the grass, your shoes get all wet, your pants get all wet, your 5-pound dog gets all wet, and well, he likes it. He gets soaking wet, he goes into the house, and then he goes racing all over the place, rolling all over the floor, getting my floor all wet. Life is good for him, and I guess I don't mind. But anyway, my mom came to visit, so I haven't been filming. My mom came to visit. Yeah, my mom came to visit. I love my mom. She came to visit from Nebraska and stayed, I believe, 3 or 4 days or something like that. We had a great time. She brought a whole carload of stuff, and most people can relate to this. When you don't live anywhere near your mom and they come to visit, I don't know what it is about moms. They, you know, I'm a middle-aged guy. And I own my own home, 2 cars. I've been around all over the country. I've done a lot of things. My mom comes to visit. I'm so glad she doesn't have a computer. Anyway, my mom comes to visit, and she brings me these big bags. And, you know, we're unpacking the car, and there's blankets. There are blankets and blankets. I don't know what she thinks I do, you know. I just lay out here in the cold or something like that. Moms just assume we never have enough blankets. We don't have any underwear. We have no food in our fridge whatsoever. You know, so she's packing, you know, she's unpacking. She goes, do you eat macaroni and cheese? Yes. Do you eat canned corn? Yes, I eat canned corn. And yeah, so I get all of this food. I get blankets. I get all kinds of stuff. And I really do appreciate it. Yeah, I do. And dishes, of course. She's bringing me these dishes and things she finds at thrift stores. And it's just amazing. So I had a great visit with my mom, but she had to leave yesterday, and so now I'm here with you, talking to you. It was a good time. I really had a great time. I love my mom, and I really enjoy every second I can with her, because she's an older woman, and I know the reality of things is she's not going to be around forever. And one of these days, I'm going to look back on this and think, you know what? That was a good day. That was a good day when she came to visit. So I just wanted to tell you that. I'm just rambling on this morning, and I had a great time with my mom. But on Facebook, I asked some of the friends on Facebook, since I've been away, I thought I'd give it viewer's choice on what they want to see in today's episode. And overwhelmingly, people wanted to see an update on the little turkey babies. They are growing fast. They are definitely growing fast. So without further rambling on for me, here are the turkey babies. Well, hey, little babies, how you doing? They're still very friendly, and they come to me when I call. I like that. They didn't turn all stupid and run away from me, but take a look at that little black thing back there. See that little bird? Yep. I went to my local farm and fleet, which is like a hardware store for farmers and stuff out in the country, and they have these stock watering tanks, and they order baby chicks and throw them in there. So you can buy chicks like one or two at a time. They have all different kinds, and I saw this little tiny black one, and boy, did he have attitude, or she. Have attitude. She was running around pecking everybody else and getting her share of food, but she was a runt. Whoops. Let's back this up. Look who just flew up and said hello. Well, hi there. Yeah. They try and get out, and I actually crawl in there
and I squat down, and they jump on my knee, and then they crawl underneath my shirt and snuggle up. Yes, I know, as bizarre as that sounds, I probably need psychological help. I crawl in there and I kneel down, and they crawl underneath my shirt and snuggle up to me and go to sleep. So I'll have all these little baby turkeys underneath my shirt, and I sit there for about maybe 20 minutes and let them feel secure. Oh, they're just adorable. I know I go on about these things, but I gotta tell you, it's amazing. They're so unlike baby chickens. They are extremely affectionate. But anyway, back to the little black guy. There's a couple chickens over there that I got. I got the little black turkey, I mean the little black chicken, and I don't know what it is. I have no idea, so we'll find out. And a couple chickens that are eating at the waterer. Those turn out to be either they're called Americanas or Araucanas. I think they go by both names. And they look so cute. I had to get them too. So now I have three extra chicken babies. I don't know if any of those are roosters, but it's going to be interesting to find out what they are, especially that little black one. That thing, the first thing he did when I tossed him in there with the turkeys, he ran over there and he pecked their butts and showed them who was boss. So he has some respect in there. I'm gonna really enjoy growing these. But I wanted to show you an update because they're just having a good old time. They're very healthy. Now, by the way, I hate to be the bearer of bad news, but one of the turkey babies didn't make it. Yeah, it was sad. It wasn't the little nugget one, the one I call Shane Nugget. It was the middle one. And he was always a little bit unhealthy. He had problems hatching. Yeah. So they generally have problems whenever they have the hatch problem. So he's gone. But the other ones, yeah, they're having fun. They're flying and peeping and having a great time. All right, we gotta go. We got other things to do. Say goodbye. This is one of the bourbon reds. She is a sweetheart. It's gotta be a she. She's very mellow. She always comes up to me and she wants to be held. Okay, me and all our friends have to go, but oh, well, hi there. Before I go, I guess this one wanted to be noticed. All right, are you done? Can I go now? They don't take any guff from me. I'm going to have a really good time. Oh, let me back up and show you where they're going to be living, okay? There is no light in here yet, so I still have a lot of work to do on this. This is just half of a garage. If you look up here, this is, ooh, I hit the wall. I came in, and beyond this wall is the other half where the chickens are. It's a chicken coop. And then on this half of the garage, it's just a garage with rafters and a back sliding door. It's an old garage, but it's sturdy. And I got some junk in it. I just store random pieces of lawn mowing machinery, garden tools, crap like that. It's got a couple windows. I am going to clear all of this crap out in the next month, or at least that's the plan, and throw down freshly mowed grass and leaves and junk. And they're going to have a good old time in here. And as soon as they're big enough, they're going to join the other birds, the chickens. I'm going to tear down this wall, and they're going to have a really huge chicken coop. Okay, I got to get going. Everybody's wet here. I'm wet, he's wet. Next episode, I'm going to be showing the fruit trees. Remember those little fruit tree sticks that I planted? It's time to prune them a little bit, and I wanted to bring you along because, in case you wanted to follow along how I do my fruit trees, I think that would be a nice episode, and also a few updates going on in the garden. There is a lot of new growth with all this rain. It's definitely doing them a lot of good. So I think that pretty much does it. Join me next time next week, and we'll go through the garden and we'll have another good day, okay? Yeah, our birds going nuts over there. It's new baby birds, blackbirds. Yeah, they're screaming for food, and their mom and dad are shoving things in their mouth. It's really kind of nice. I love it. I don't go over there because I don't want to scare them off or freak them out or ruin their routine, but it's fun to watch. It is. Okay, I got to get going. Thanks for joining me in the garden. I really do appreciate it. Have a great day, everybody. Bye.